All right, as we are honing closer and closer to Season 3, we're still getting those weekly updates from Embark Studios, and today we're going to break down Update 2.8.0. First of all, for the gadgets, nothing crazy has changed this week. We do have an adjustment to the anti-gravity cube, which is essentially making it heavier so it doesn't get pushed around as much, followed then by some bugs and gadgets on the dome shield. As for gameplay, we have a new arena carryable object in the game. This is called Glitch Barrels. That's right, and the devs note here that Glitch Barrels are obviously carryable objects. Pick them up and throw them to apply their effect in the arena, or shoot them to detonate them from afar. Glitch Barrels apply the same effect as Glitch Grenades, removing their target's ability to use their gadgets and specializations. So it's actually quite interesting because obviously, you know, if used correctly, it could actually be kind of used as a great entry tool on top of, you know, the kit that you might already have as a contestant, right? Initially, I don't really think that, you know, it's going to change that much, you know, about the game. It's not, you know, something that is incredibly revolutionary, but as you know, the more people that kind of experiment with this stuff, the more crazier things that obviously, you know, they could find. Embark have also targeted some additions to the ping wheel, which is focusing a lot more on communication options for your team. There are now two messages for the ping wheel. We have breach here and hold this position. Embark have also changed up the hype and danger pings, where hype is now in the expression wheel. So don't worry, you can still spam hype if your team gets wiped, and it's a very toxic ping. Danger is now shown when you double tap the ping button on any target. Going here, defending here, and attacking here in the ping wheel are now called go here, defend here, and attack here, just to essentially make it a lot more clearer that they're requests to your team and also consistent with the character's voice lines as well. Also, a very quick smaller issue, which was very common that is now changed, is they actually updated the required round completion on the terminal attack contract from 10 to the intended 14. So I know a lot of people were kind of wondering why they didn't fully unlock their contracts, or why they didn't unlock the hoodie. That's essentially why. So you might have to play a couple more games of Terminal Attack if you haven't already. For specializations, Charge and Slam can now clear higher obstacles when activated on the ground to reduce instances where players get stuck on geometry. So I'm assuming the area of effect kind of got slightly increased here. So that's kind of what I'm gonna pin it as. All right, now for the weapons. I hope, obviously, you dagger mains are going to be happy, okay? I know that there's been a lot of issues for you guys over the past couple of weeks. The issue most of you spotted recently has been fixed in this update, which essentially is that they've improved the backstab validation, okay? They did mention here in the dev note, they said, we received a lot of feedback about backstabs not feeling as good. Hopefully, we've rectified this issue in this patch. Obviously, the only way to tell is to let you guys try it and obviously gather your feedback afterwards, so let them try it, and if in the comment section it still doesn't feel right or there's still an issue, let me know in the comments, and I can then pass the you know, comments to the developers as well from my community. So let's help each other, boys. They've also fixed the dagger so that the aim assist for backstabs now actually synchronizes with the swing rather than actually triggering at the start of the charge up. I think this is great because when I was testing out the dagger myself, just to kind of get a feel for how like that weapon works, there was a couple of things that I didn't really like as much with the aim assist, so hopefully that's a bit of a better improvement for you guys. They've actually improved hit validation for all melee weapons, okay? So what you'll what will happen is you guys will notice that a lot more attacks do actually connect with maybe that poor lonely AKM medium player, you know, in the corner of the map just trying to live life. But something I really like here is that for the melee is that there's now a setting to turn melee aim assist on or off in the gameplay section. I mean, this is great because as I said earlier, I noticed something playing that the aim assist was quite strong and kind of like threw me off, I guess, quite a lot of times when attacking. So I think it's obviously a great addition for those that don't really need or want that aim assist in the game. If you do still like the aim assist though, then the aim assist and lunge range are slightly more generous now for quick melee instead of charge attacks, so it's actually quite nice as well. They close off the statements with changes to melee weapons by mentioning some other additions like change to sprinting whilst attacking and sprint toggle features. Another smaller nod here as well is if you're a Riot Shield user, is that the shield can now be raised faster after performing an attack, so you might notice some increased survivability here. So I've noticed obviously there hasn't really been much changes or adjustments to, you know, things like the stun gun. Obviously we knew that that was quite a controversial topic in the community. People are very, very torn on the state of the stun gun right now, and it looks like, you know, kind of surprising to me is that Ember kind of holding firm and standing strong with the stun gun state right now. I know obviously light is not the most viable in rank, for example. Like recently, thanks to Ruby and Tiago, we managed to get to diamond. I think I'm nearly diamond 3 now. And we very rarely saw a light in our games, right? I mean, if we did, we might see like a light sniper, for example. But you know, apart from that, like it was an incredibly rare scenario. You know, and is that because of the stun gun? I don't really think so. I mean, let's be real, boys. I think it's just, you know, light at the higher level overall is a lot more less viable for being added into, you know, a team, for example. So if there are light mains out there that are very good, then obviously they'll happily use light at a high level. But in ranked, for example, for the more casual or competitive player base, I don't know, I just feel like light's not that viable right now. But when you look at, you know, less high stakes games like Power Shift, for example, or you go into, you know, maybe a Bankit, light is incredibly dominant in those modes. So it's a very strange scenario right now for what the position that light's in. All right, here we are in the game. As you can see, we got that diamond 4. I'm pretty happy about that. Obviously it's not like a crazy big achievement, but it's nice because I hardly have time to play ranks. I'm doing these videos for you guys. Okay, so the store this week, boom, look at this. We have the Koro Gatosaurus. We have my long lost brother, boys. Not extinct, just recycled right there. Oh, there's some numbers on the back too. Maybe some little hints here to some Easter egg stuff, guys. This is my long lost brother, boys. We got the cardboard box boys up, boys. We are up. Yeah, dude. This is cool, man. Yeah, boys, we got the dino drip. We got the dino drip, boys. Hell yeah. There's a little bit of clipping here, but that's fine. But look at this. This is so, so cool. All they gotta do is reskin this, and we good. And we in the game. Okay, we also have a Nama Timekeeper right here. If you guys like the watch drip in the game, there is some more watch drip right here. This is the correct time as well. I think this is right. I don't know how to read this. The time is weird. Just don't call this an egg timer in front of Nama Timer. True, that is very, very true. So we have the arcade carpet set. Pay homage to the sites where legends stood and entered their three-letter monikers to memorize their high scores. Yeah, this does give that kind of nostalgia, actually. This is actually quite nice. It's like a very slight mix between, like, you know, a very kind of messy mess around skin, like a fun skin, and like more of like a not over the top skin. Like it's a very like gray zone. I really love this kind of like bubblegum color theme with like the pink and blue. A little bit of nostalgia to some people, of course. We have a coin, arcade token only. That's sick. That is actually cool. No cash value. Very, very nice. Again, you can now buy things individually. So I like this coin, this arcade token coin, but I do really like this scar. I'm gonna buy the scar skin individually, by the way. Super, super cool edition and box. This is really, really nice. This is my drip right now that we have right here for the game. Okay, so obviously we are getting closer and closer towards you know, season 3, obviously. I do have obviously some other bigger videos coming very soon as well. Shout out to Piggy, we'll be doing a podcast very soon as well. So if you guys want to hear more from the true legend, the true number one light, I'll be obviously talking to Piggy shortly as well. And guys, also I forgot to say, I'm doing a live stream Saturday. So today is Thursday. So you have Thursday, Friday, Saturday. If you guys want to hang out with me, Goofy our player, we're going to be testing out a new game called Combat Champions. It's a, you know, some people saying it's the finals competitor or whatever. So we're gonna try it out and just, you know, give our honest opinions on it and thoughts, and you know, help the developers over there. It's not sponsored or anything. It's just I want to just see what a new game. I want to see what, you know, the grass tastes like on the other side. You know, so I'm gonna test it out. All right, guys, that is pretty much everything this week so far. Thank you all so, so much for supporting me once again. We have some crazy content and stuff coming up for you guys in the near future as well. So thank you all for being my motivation to do YouTube. You guys are awesome. Thank you. Much love. I guess, as always, my name's Finn Thix, and I'll see you on the podium.